Hi, I'm Gailen David.
And I'm Bobby Laurie. We're the Savvy Stews. You know, we live our lives on the road, and a lot of the time, that takes us overseas.
The last thing we want to do is create an international incident.
You know, you're really good at that.
I know, but we've come up with some simple ways to make travel
less frightening
and more fun.
One of the first things we like to do when we get to a hotel overseas is grab a business card from the front desk.
Yes, and I've got one here, and I love it because it has the name of the hotel and the address. Mm-hmm. You can show it to someone on the street or a taxi driver, and even though they speak English in most countries, it's nice to at least make an effort, right?
You know, it's supposed to help you if you get lost, but I believe that card from Geneva didn't help you get back to the hotel in the time.
Oh my gosh, you're still holding on to that.
Yeah, we're not gonna forget it.
I see. Before departing to an international destination, you really need to double check this passport expiration date.
Why?
Well, because every time I was overseas, they were saying, sir, your passport is expiring in 6 months.
Well, didn't you know that the State Department will actually let you use your passport until the date inside the cover? But some destinations will actually turn away international travelers if the passport expires within 6 months because they want to make sure you're going to be able to get home in the event you get delayed or stuck over there. That's why I like to get it renewed 9 months before I leave.
Well, but what about if you want to extend your vacation indefinitely?
Then you just go.
Oh, okay.
As you know, most flights internationally from the United States are red-eye flights. So
yes.
In order to get a good night's rest, I like to travel with my own eye mask because you don't really get these for free anymore.
Right, and you know what? I've got to have my medicine bag because it's got my Aleve, my NyQuil, my Imodium. Mm-hmm. I mean, every city in Europe has a pharmacy, but do you really know how to say diarrhea in German?
No, I don't. But you know, it's also really important if you do take prescription medication to get it refilled before you leave and pack it in your carry-on bag because once you check your bag, you're not getting it back. Even if you ask the flight attendants, they can't do it either.
Yeah, that's just the movie.
In the movies.
Another very expensive lesson I learned is that when you travel internationally, you've got to have the right data roaming plans. I mean, listen, I had literally thousands of dollars in data roaming charges on that trip.
I remember because it totally served you right, too. See, I planned ahead and I switched to a cell phone company that's got free texting and free data internationally. In fact, when you land, you get a text message that perfectly details the rate you're going to pay, so there's no surprises, and most of it's free.
I know, and my fix was that I got this phone unlocked and switched to your carrier.
What are you going to do with all the extra money you saved?
Well, I was thinking of maybe having some work done.
It's about that time for you, isn't it? These tips aside, the smartest and most important thing you can do is get a good night's rest the night before your international departure.
It'll really get your trip off to a great start. You don't have to worry about any photos from the night before ending up plastered on social media.
Yeah, I've taken a few of those.
For more information and to travel like we do, visit SavvyStews.com.